Hello friends and welcome back. So in this series we are discussing various numericals on nodal analysis. So this is another numerical. This numerical is complicated as compared to previous numericals given in part 1 and 2. The links are available in description. Okay, so we will see this numerical. So here we have to find the values of I1, I2 and I3. Three currents we have to calculate using nodal analysis. Okay. So when any numerical is given on nodal analysis, your first step is to identify various nodes, but here already your nodes are indicated. Okay, so V1, V2 and V3, three nodes voltages are given. It means three nodes are already indicated. Okay, and then next step is to indicate the various currents. So here currents are also given in advance. So I1, I2 and I3, these are our three currents. Now next step is to apply KCL, but before applying KCL, let us find out what are the known node voltages. So V3 is nothing but it is connected to positive terminal of 4 volt, so V3 node voltage becomes 4 volt. Similarly, V1 is connected to positive of this 4 volt. Okay, so this node voltage becomes plus 4 volt. Okay, and now V2 is unknown to us, so we will apply KCL at unknown node. So we will apply KCL at node 2 so that we will get voltage V2 like this. Now KCL indicates sum of incoming currents is equal to outgoing currents, so we will get this equation. I1 is equal to I2 plus I3, because here I1 is the only incoming current towards V2, then I2 and I3 both are outgoing currents, so we will get this equation. Now you know that according to Ohm's law, I is equal to voltage upon resistance. So we will write all this current in terms of voltages. Okay. Now what is I1? So if you look at this circuit, I1 is flowing from node 1 to node 2. Okay. So what we will write? Starting voltage V1 minus end voltage V2. Okay. But in between these two voltages, 2 volt is again present over here. So whatever intermediate voltage is present in the path of this current, that also must be considered. Okay, so subtract this voltage, whatever voltage present in this path, that voltage must be subtracted. But again, while subtracting, one thing you have to remember, you have to subtract it with specific polarity. So what is this voltage? 2 volt. Okay, and now you have to use that polarity of this 2 volt. Now how current is entering? Current is entering from negative terminal of this 2 volt. Okay, so you have to subtract minus 2 from this start volt and end volt. Okay, if the current is entering from positive terminal of this 2 volt, then here we will get minus in bracket plus 2 volt. So whatever terminal in which current is entering, that sign should be used over here. Okay, and this should be divided by resistance. Now what is the resistance present from this point to this point? So again we are having 2 ohm and 3 ohm in series, so we have to add these two resistances, so 2 plus 3. Okay, so this is the novelty in this equation. Okay, now what is I2? I2 is flowing from V2 towards ground. Ground potential is 0 volt, you know. Okay, so V2 minus 0 means V2 divided by what is the old resistance you are having, 2 ohm plus. Now what is I3? I3 is flowing from V2 towards V3, so V2 minus V3, start voltage minus end voltage divided by resistance, it is flowing through 2 ohm. So this is the equation you are getting. Okay, now solve this equation and cross multiply on the right hand side, so you are getting, this is the equation you are getting. Okay, now again cross multiply this, take 4 this side and 5 on the right hand side, and again this 2v2 and 2v2, 4v2 we are getting. So final equation comes out. So this equation you are getting. Now V1 and V3 are known to us, only unknown thing is V2. So put the values of V1 and V3. So your V1 is how much? 4 volt. And what is V3? It is again 4 volt. So put the value in this equation you are getting. So we have substituted the values of V1 and V3 over here. Now solve this, you are getting this equation. Now take V2 terms on one side and constant terms on other side, you are getting this equation. You are getting, now from this you will get the value of V2 as 2.667 volt. So this is your voltage at node 2. So friends, now V2 we have calculated, V1 and V3 are already known to us, they are given in the network. Okay, so all node voltages are now known to us. Now we can calculate any value of current. So basically we have to calculate I1, I2 and I3. Okay, so we can calculate I1, I2 and I3 by putting the value of V2. Okay, so it will be like this. So friends, now this is your voltage V1. It was given as 4 volt. V3 was also 4 volt. And V2 we have calculated. Now we can calculate I1, I2 and I3. So formulas for I1, I2 and I3. We have already written those formulas over here. So this was your I1, this was your I2 and this was your I3. Same formula we have written over here. Now we will substitute the values of V1, V2 and V3 respectively in this formula, and we will get the values of I1, I2 and I3 after calculations. So your answers are like this. So this you are getting, after doing the calculations, you will get the values of I1, I2 and I3 as, so I1 comes out to be 0.667 ampere, I2 comes out 1.33 ampere and I3 comes out to be -0.667 amperes. Okay, so in this way you can calculate current flowing through the various branches in the network using nodal analysis. Now again we will draw one conclusion from this. So first of all I will write I1, I2 and I3 values together like this. So friends, we have got the values of I1, I2 and I3 like this. Okay, now if you look at this, what you can observe, I1 and I2 values are positive whereas I3 value is negative. So these signs have specific meaning. If your answer comes out to be positive, it indicates that whatever direction of current we have assumed, it is correct, means I1 is actually flowing like this. Again, I2 is positive, means I2 is actually flowing from V2 towards ground. But I3 answer comes out to be negative. So this indicates that current is not flowing from V2 towards V3. In practice, or actually practically, your current will be flowing from V3 towards V2. So if answer is negative, it indicates that actually your current is flowing in the reverse direction. Okay, so by using nodal analysis, not only we can calculate the current, but we can also find the value of we can also find the direction of current in which it is flowing. Okay, so positive answer indicates our assumed direction is correct, and negative answer indicates current is actually flowing in the reverse direction which we have assumed. Okay, so thank you very much for watching this. So this completes our series on nodal analysis. If you are having any doubts or difficulties, please ask in the comment section. And if you really like this video, please press the like button and do not forget to subscribe my channel. So thank you very much. Have a nice day.